All right, next on our list here with this ProLogic control is our auxiliary pump. The auxiliary pump is that pump right there, and that pump right there is your Polaris pump. That will control your robot cleaner that's sitting right there. So here in a minute, I'm going to show you how to hook that up. But anyway, all you have to do, the light's off right now. If you hit that auxiliary pump, if you can see it there, it says auxiliary one turned on. So that is your auxiliary pump, which is your Polaris cleaner pump. Okay? Now this, there is a Aqua Comfort heat pump on this unit, and it is right there. The way that you work that is, if you, on your menu, if you go to the settings menu and then you arrow over, you see the pool heater one is off, the super chlorinate is off. Now super chlorinate, we'll get to that real quick. What that is, if you have a heavy bather load, you can hit the plus button and the super chlorinate will turn on, and it will generate 100% chlorine from the salt generator for 24 hours, and then it will go back to the 55% that it was originally on. But we're gonna turn that off for right now. And there you see the pool chlorinator's on 55%. If you find that you need more chlorine in your pool, you can just arrow up to increase it, or arrow down to decrease the amount of chlorine. There you can set your day and time. That's just for the lights. That if you want the beeper to sound when you're pushing buttons, you can push the plus button and enable the beeper. That's for the wireless. You would push plus to teach your wireless to start. That's the wireless channel that it's on. And we're still on settings menu, but I'm going to go back to the heater. Right now the pool heater is off. If I arrow up, there it's 65, I just keep arrowing up. And what this is doing is, this is what temperature you would want the water in the pool. Right now the water temperature is about 88 or 89 degrees. So if you listen closely, you'll probably hear the heat pump turn on. There. Right now I've got it set at 91 degrees and the heat pump turned on. When the temperature reaches 91 degrees, the heat pump will turn off and it'll maintain it at that temperature. So you just push the plus button to increase your temperature that you desire, the minus button to reduce it, and you set it to what temperature you want the pool, and then the Aqua Comfort heat pump will heat your pool to that temperature and maintain it. Now, to turn the heat pump off, I'm just going to keep arrowing down, and it will get to, there we go, up, went too far. All right, there it goes to off, and it's going to take just a second, because the heater wants to cycle to make sure it has water going through it. But that heater will turn off here just in a second. And that's how you operate the heater for the pool. So what I'm gonna do right now is I'm gonna let that heater turn off. And then I'm going to show you how to clean the basket, the strainer basket, and the pool pump. But while we're doing that, I'm gonna give this back. I'm going to do one more thing here. This is a Jandy cartridge filter. On this filter, the water comes into the filter there, it comes out of the filter there, goes underground, over into the heat pump, through your salt generator, and then back into your pool return, which is the actuated valve, and the other valve is the valve for your jet. Now these two valves right here, we have them labeled. This one is your skimmer valve. Right now it's about halfway open. This valve right here, this is your main drain. So you're drawing the water from the pool right here. This valve right here that's on this Polaris pump, that valve right there, that just, if you need to do some maintenance on this pump, you can just turn that valve off so you can do maintenance on the pump. But when you run the Polaris, you always want to make sure that that valve is open. But on this Jandy heat pump, on this Jandy cartridge filter, right here there's a bleeder valve. And I'm going to open that up. and that just, that lets air out of the filter. And then to clean this filter, I'm gonna give this back to my cameraman. All right, click it off back there.